Hello, welcome again, guys. So today we'll be talking about the different types of bees, and inside the hive you'll find three types of bees. So you'll find the drones, the workers, and the queen. But today we'll start off with the queen bee, right? The queen bee is the mother of the hives. Some would say she's the boss lady, and as her name states, the queen royalty. So the queen, she's larger in size than the other bees. Like for instance, the worker bee, she's much taller. She has a long, slender abdomen. That's the back part of her. And that part consists of like the eggs and the sperms that she takes and she keeps. And it also consists of her stinger too. But she uses her abdomen for egg laying. She will use that to put inside the cells and deposit the egg. Anyway, she is the primary egg layer of the hive, right? And the queen can lay up to 2,000 eggs per day. Some say even up to 3,000. And these eggs are the source of all new bees in the hive, right? They also release this chemical that controls the colony. And it will let the worker bees know that she's the primary layer, so they will refuse to lay. They won't lay. And it controls the movements and other different things. For instance, like swarming, it will tell them that they need to prepare themselves to swarm, just in case there's something wrong with the queen or they need to requeen. For instance, if she's injured or something, she's not laying as much as she used to, they will decide if they want to create a new queen. But we'll talk about requeening and all those things down more. Yeah, also about the queen bee. So the queen bee can live at least 2 years. Some say 3, 4, 5, up to 7 years, some people find. But at least 2 years. So she live much longer than all the other bees inside the hive. And the queen bee has a stinger. Her stinger, it doesn't stay like the worker bees, because the worker bees, those stinger have like barbs on it, but hers is just pointed. And she uses hers mostly to defend herself or to kill other queens, like rival queen inside the hive. For example, when a new queen is born, or when the workers create new queens from specially selected cells, right? They feed those eggs royal jelly up to a special time. And when that queen emerge, the first queen that emerge out of that cell is the one that goes around trying to eliminate all the others. So that's where they use their stinger. So they use their stinger to really kill the other ones inside their hive, inside the cells. The drones bees are the male bees of the hive, and their role mainly is for mating with the queen, right? So they're much larger in size than the worker bees, and their abdomen is much thicker, like it's much fatter, right? And they have larger eyes, like their eyes take up all of their head, like they're bigger eyes, right? And the Jones bees doesn't have stingers, like they don't have a stinger, because their purpose is for mostly mating. They don't even defend the hive. And Jones bees are really developed from unfertilized eggs. For instance, when the queen lay, those are the eggs that's not fertilized by any sperm. So that's where you get the Jones bees. And the worker bees is also, sometimes they will lay. If they lay, it will definitely become a Jones bees, because they don't have any sperms either to fertilize any eggs. That's why you really need a queen. But anyway, we're talking about the drones. So the drones, their lifespan is much shorter. They can live a few weeks, maybe like, as some would say, maybe like 30 to 60 days maximum, you know, because once they develop from larva stage to and become drones, all their job is to just prepare themselves for the mating, right, of a queen, mating with a queen. Right, and you only find them present inside a box, mostly during like summertime peak seasons. For instance, when there's like lots of food, and like you look outside, there's like lots of vegetation, like you see lots of nectar, things blooming, all this stuff. You'll find once there's lots of food source, you'll find lots of drones, because that's the time I've decided to populate. Like they will split off, or you'll find young queens preparing themselves for mating flights and all these things. So you'll find lots of drones during that season. And
Another thing about the drones, they don't really feed themselves. They depend on the workers to feed them. So they will go around towards the workers and with their tongue out, and the workers will put food on it. They'll feed them with honey, right? They'll feed them with food, those food. So basically, the drones, he save his energy. So, and another thing too, before I even get to that part, a lot of people call the drones, they say they're lazy. They're the lazy bees, right? Means said because they don't go outside and do any foraging. You won't find them at the entrance of the hive, like they're guarding the hive, because they don't have a stinger, so they can't guard the hive. And they don't go outside to go get pollen or nectar, because they, on their legs, they don't have any sack to keep, no ears and all those things on their legs, like the worker bees, to collect pollen. So they wouldn't be a good forager if they even wanted to, right? They weren't designed for that. Their main design was for mating, to keep the colony fertile. Right? So, with that said now, the Jones bees, he's not really lazy. He's smart. He saves his energy. Because during a mating flight, only the fittest of the fittest can mate with the queen. Because they have to be fast. If the queen is going 15, 20 miles per hour, the male, the Jones, he has to go at that speed or even faster to catch up to, with her. Because if he's behind and she's going 20, he has to go at least 22 or more than 20 to catch up with her. And she's only going to mate with a few of them. So it's only the fittest of the fittest can mate. By sitting around eating and getting fat and developing all this energy, it's just in preparation for the mating. So he's not really lazy. He's smart when it comes down to that aspect of the bees, right? And another thing about the drones, you won't find a lot of drones during the winter time. Because during the winter time, the food source outside, for example, I'll tell you about Canada, because right now we're doing a little thing in Canada, right? But the Canadian winter is very harsh. Nothing survives. Like, for instance, when you look outside, there's no plants, no vegetation. You may see a little few green stuff and things, but they're not blooming. There's no pollen or nothing like that. No nectar during winter time, because it's too cold, the snow. So during that time, the workers basically starve the drones or kick them out of the hive, because they eat a lot and they don't do much inside the hive to help the colony, right? So, and they're not, and during that time, during the winter time, the queen is not looking to, the hive is not looking to branch off or I say populate into another hive or make themselves bigger, right? They're not looking to developing a young queen during the winter time. So they starve them, they don't feed them, or they evict them from the hive. Because they have to, during the winter time now, the workers have to think, say, all right, since there's not enough food source outside, whatever we have inside have to keep us until the end of winter, until spring come again when things start to bloom and these vegetation come back, right? So what they do, they cut off the ration, they cut it off. They don't limit it, they cut it off, and then what they have now, they limit it to their self, like the workers, the queen, and the young larvae, the eggs that's hatching, the few eggs that the queen is laying per day, because she doesn't lay that much during winter time, right? It's limited, because they only can move. They bungle themselves in a bundle, and they don't move around a lot, like during the summertime or warmer temperature. So, we'll get into that part of it and talk about all those things about winter beekeeping and all of that. Once they cut off the ration from the drones, it's either they die and then the worker take them out, or they evict them. They just push them outside the hive and then they will die. That's why some drones don't live for more than a few months, 2 months maximum, right? And then we go back now to where the drone's abdomen is much thicker, because he has to store his sperms inside of that, right? And that's where, you know, his stinger, he doesn't use a stinger. So where his stinger is, that's where his sperms is. So when he goes on a mating flight with a queen and they engage, once they separate, he dies, because all of his organs comes out of him. Once a drone bees mate with a queen, he dies, and the queen collect all those sperms, and then she will come back to the hive and then she'll start laying. Yeah. But so the drones will save his energy, as I told you, for that day. When they say, all right, so every day, what they will do, once they are well fed and they're satisfied, they will go outside and go to other hives. Because they have this place that's where all the drones meet, and that's like a mating area. So all the drones from different hives, they go up and they meet, like a they congregate together up there waiting for a queen, a young virgin queen to fly. And then that's when the mating game starts. So they will go from box to box and try and see if there's any young queen emerging and all these things. So it's all about the science of beekeeping. So the hive works good, you know, that way. But we have to give thanks and knowing that it's all a miracle, right? And a blessing from the Most High. So we give thanks for that. But they're not just lazy bees. They're the male. They're like semi-royalty because they don't even feed themselves. Only when the ration get less, the workers will cut that off. And that's about it for Jones.